Every job you give him, every chore you give him, it takes about 6 months for it to get completed.
I
have to be, one second, I have to be zen-like to tolerate him, but he cooks like a dream. Yeah. So he doesn't like cleaning and he's not a chef.
Yeah. Why would he clean? She has to clean. Yeah. And I cook her food.
Yeah. And he will never keep anything that he picks up from the place that it's designated to.
No chef
never,
does.
Ever.
Hi guys, I am Vibhu Raghav and Unwrap with Vibhu mein aapka swagat hai. Aur humare jo aaj guest hain, they are really amazing individuals who make super amazing couple together. So please welcome Maninee Mishra and Mihir Mishra. Hi guys.
Cheers.
Hi.
Thanks for coming by. So a lot of you know that I worked with Maninee on my first show on Channel B. It was called Supreme Google. And that reminds me of my first meeting with her. So bahar makeup van lagi hui thi and I just walked in to say hi to her. I walk in and I'm like, okay, so Maninee is here and she's like a senior artist.
And you met the devil.
You're intimidated and everything. And she's getting her makeup done and I said hi's and hellos and we started talking. 5 minutes went by and the makeup dada is looking at me like, when is he gonna leave? When the fuck is he gonna leave? And I asked Mana politely twice, Mana, you get your makeup done and tab tak I would not even call you Mana, I would call you like Maninee.
Yeah, yeah.
I said, I'll see you afterwards. And she's like, no, you just chill now, stand here. Let's talk, it's going good. And I was so scared. I thought, agar makeup kuch kharab ho gaya, scene mein achhi nahi lagi, then she's gonna kill me for that. So from there till here, I mean, it's been super amazing and she's literally part of my family that way. And about you, one of my first memories which stands out, I mean, is
don't
Diwali.
Don't tell me you were a kid when you don't you ever bloody
you.
Say that.
Don't
you ever bloody say I was
I
a
grew
child,
up watching you.
I was wearing a diaper when you saw my fucking show. No, don't you ever bloody say that.
No.
I'll have to change your diaper now.
Patience, father, patience.
So it was Diwali, I came to your
home. Yes. Yeah,
and your dog, Cuddles.
Yes, Cuddles.
Oh my god, she's one.
Fangoli took the name because I am also considered as a dog at home. Yeah. We have two dogs.
So
she has two dogs.
Yeah. So Cuddles is going hyper, she's jumping on the couch and everything, and we are talking, we are wishing Diwali, whatever, and he's drinking. And at some point he puts the glass down and 2 minutes later, I see Cuddles yapping up from the glass and 2 minutes
like
further...
Like father, like daughter, man. I mean, Diwali hai to peene hai.
2 minutes further, she calmed down. Like she was like a really well-settled dog.
Zen.
Yeah, like zen. Thing. And it was just amazing. Like I've never
after
seen that
you left, the hangover happened. Yeah, she threw
up. Yeah, our dog likes alcohol, yeah.
My previous dog liked champagne. This one likes whiskey.
Not that she's we more feed our dogs with alcohol.
No, no. They just Peter, we do not do
yeah,
that.
Yeah, we don't. Yeah. We just love our dogs.
So what is your first memory of each other?
When I saw her crossing the road. No, actually, I didn't saw her crossing the road. When I first saw her, I just wanted to have sex.
Yeah, and I'm not stumped, okay? So yeah, it's like pheromone thing and, you know, whatever. No, and hormones and stuff like that. Mm. But I met him during my shoot, which was at Cinevista, which is the same place that both of us were shooting. And I was going up the stairs and he was coming down the stairs and his leg was broken. So I just asked him most politely, may I help you with your bags? And I do that to anybody or for anybody. And he just looked at me and he said, no, thank you, my driver's coming. So I said, okay, and I walked past. And apparently that's when he just turned around and looked up and
I felt I want to have sex.
Yeah, so he wanted to have sex. Yeah, so we're not one of those.
Count them up.
So we're not one
and
of those.
And imagine 13 years later, I'm still demanding that.
So
I still want to have it.
So who asked who out first?
I asked you out first.
No, I asked you out first.
Seriously?
Okay, no, sorry. So we were invited for a Diwali party. Yeah, so technically I asked him out.
No, Diwali party you never asked
not
me.
Not Diwali party.
Diwali
poster,
party,
marriage.
I made sure you attended the Diwali party.
Yeah, but married. I'm talking about married.
Married, I asked you out.
Okay,
you didn't ask
okay,
me
he
out.
Asked me out.
Okay, so of course nobody played sex hard to get.
No, I don't believe in all that. It's too much waste
Peter
of.
Peter was anyway desperate.
Yeah, no. It's,
I was already too hard. I swear to get her.
No, my whole thing is, the wooing process is beautiful and all that. But in today's world, it has to be done at a certain pace. And I don't really have the patience. I love conversations. So we did have a lot of conversations. And that's what connected us to each other. But this whole thing of, you know, ye rose or ye rose, mujhse wo sab nahi hota. I'm more.
Actually, let me just cut it short. I just, the day I met her, I told her, listen, I've had girlfriends. I've
Don't believe in engagements and fiancés
because you know what? You give a goddamn, you buy an expensive ring, you give it to her, then you break up. You don't have the balls to ask the ring back. So I said, why the hell would I want to waste my money in giving a ring and saying, abhi todna hai. So I said, ring, chodo, ye sab chodo, shaadi karni to bolo. And then I gave her enough time to choose. I said, just tell me by tomorrow.
So 24 hours is what I was given to decide whether I wanted to be with him or not for the rest of my life.
Wow.
3 days and we were married.
And here you are.
And not knowing each other, not dating each other. We never knew each other. We never dated each other. 3 days, bang on, we were married.
Wow. So, out of the three of you in the family, I mean, both of you and your daughter, Diano.
Yeah.
I mean, who's the alpha, beta, gamma of the pack?
Alpha, beta, gamma.
I would think alpha.
You think so?
I would think this is just getting over right now. Is there a knife in the house? I have never killed a man. I would like to try it first time in my life.
No, he looks...
Actually, it's alpha, beta, gamma. I just give her the credit.
Okay, so...
Father.
Okay, yeah. So how do you guys resolve your disagreements?
Argue.
Whoever shouts,
scream.
Whoever shouts the loudest.
Yeah. We're not that couple, you know, it says ki hum to kabhi ladai nahi
karte. Actually, the neighbors solve a problem.
Yeah.
So they think, we heard Mihir was louder.
Shut up.
So the vote goes to him.
Don't you dare.
When you're louder... You win.
No, nothing like that. Nothing. And with no disrespect meant to anybody who doesn't fight, but we are a living, feisty, full of life, mad fire signs who just love a good fight. And we don't believe in saying, nahi, hum to kabhi nahi. We don't agree. We don't agree. We don't agree. We agree. And I like it like this. Had I somebody who agreed too much, I'd be bored and I'd dump him.
So, I mean, you guys are so amazing together, but does the chemistry of other couples around you affect your equation? I mean, does it become a variable in your equation or you're able to keep it separate?
Okay, elaborate.
No, simple. If somebody is very perfect, so would I come and tell you?
No.
So you have your own.
Yeah.
It doesn't matter what
you have. Our alchemy, our algorithm is totally different.
Yeah, we have.
It doesn't really.
No. But of course, we admire qualities in people. But no, I think because.
It doesn't affect us.
Yeah, because we understand each other's individuals.
So you don't fight with each other about, okay, you know, they are so good or they are so comparable or whatever, you know, they say sorry to each other and we don't, whatever.
No, not really.
Not at all. We're too busy fighting with each other and...
No, we're individuals and we understand that, you know, that their alchemy is different, our alchemy
in a relationship, if we do not fight and somebody tells me,
what are you saying? Do you... Is it a very...
We are perfect the way we are and we do not
have time to think about it.
So, I mean, of course, you're artists, you're great looking people. When somebody hits on you, do you guys come back home and discuss it?
Oh, yes.
I didn't expect it that much.
We do.
But how does it go?
You go first.
No, so I just tell him, you know, that if I mention somebody's name very often and then suddenly he's going to turn and say, so I'm like, no, but he was being polite. He was like, it's known as politeness nowadays. But also he really rags me.
Okay, what I do is, I hit back. If I get a response, I don't tell her. If I don't, I come and tell her that the picture's hitting on me. The picture's hitting on me.
No, he's lying.
She's mad.
So,
if I get a response, then it all happens.
There is no possessiveness, no jealousy. I mean...
I'm not a very possessive.
No, she's
person.
Possessed, but not possessed.
No, I'm possessed. I'm possessed.
There's no possessiveness, but she's possessed.
No, we're not really possessive people. But when I see... my territory is being threatened. I do piss on my territory. Yes, I'm very clear about
territorial.
It. Territorial sometimes. Very seldom.
Now I know why the bed is smelling the way it's been smelling.
Yes.
You've been pissing too much.
With the dog.
Okay, so now that we're talking truthfully, so we'll start with the next segment, which is called Geeta Ki Saugand.
Yes.
So, aapka cell phone...
Geeta Ki Saugand!
मेरी एक्स गर्लफ्रेंड भी गीता होती थी उसी की सौगंध दे रही है
और गीता फुटबॉल बोल के
गीता माय डार्लिंग इन न्यूयॉर्क यू विल बी टर्निंग इन योर बेड नाउ
सो ऑफ कोर्स आप सौगंध खा के बोलते
हैं
मैं गीता की सौगंध खाती
हूं
आप सब सच सच बोलेंगे
सच सच बोलेंगे
एंड इट्स अ रैपिड फायर यस
क्विकली
राइट सो हु इज मोर लाइकली टू पिक अप अ फाइट
राइट
ओके हु इज मोर जेनरस विद कॉम्प्लीमेंट्स
Rapid fire, answer the question.
Yeah, okay.
You can deny.
Yeah.
You can completely deny.
Yeah.
Who points more fingers at the other person? You do?
At him.
Okay, who's more likely to say sorry first? To resolve?
Both.
Oh fuck.
Both.
That was good. That was good. You know. No truth in it, but yeah.
Who's more romantic?
Yeah.
Not romantic.
Who's more likely to trash the house if left on their own.
Oh no, on their own? No, trash isn't how elaborate. Break
no, Ganda Karna. Ganda Karna.
Ah, ha, ha. Well, easy.
Okay, who has the duty to switch off the last light?
They break the mic? No, sorry. Sorry, come again.
So, who has the duty to switch off the last light before the bedtime? You don't push him for that?
I'm in bed, babe, before the lights turned off.
No, he just goes off to sleep, so.
So, coming back to conversation, and now that we are talking openly about stuff, I heard that initially a lot of people were skeptical about you two, like, you know, as a relationship lasting long enough.
Yeah. Bets were placed on our marriage. Wagers, wagers. Yes.
So, thank you. See, I have the best makeup data in the
yes,
world.
Yes, yes.
Carry on, carry on. Enough.
So,
okay. Stop!
Oh, shit. Touch up, I can't do.
Mm. So, I mean, why was that? And did it affect you guys?
Because this is my second marriage, firstly. And in India, there's this whole thing of, you know, oh my God, she's going to get married the second time. It better be, you know, thought out. And yes, of course, why not? A, because it was at the speed of lightning. So most people thought it's just an impulse. And B, because we'd not dated each other. So there was no talk about us being in a relationship.
It was directly to
plus wedding. Plus because I was divorced, you see. So my track record was bad.
Track record just once you were divorced.
No. But then people in this country have this thing of saying, oh, bichari ka divorce, okay, oh, what happened?
For me, it was very simple. I just saw her and I just wanted her and I just wanted to spend the rest of my life. And I don't want to sound like a cliche. Maybe can I grow old and all? No, not all of that. I just said, this is it. I think this woman seems like the right woman to be with. If not, aage jaake dekhenge kya hota hai.
And also, I think a lot of people thought my energy is too individualistic in that sense, and I'd not be able to merge my energies with someone on a long-term thing. I just like to tell those people who are judgmental that, you know.
Oh, by the way, you should tell him that people actually played a satta on our
That's what it just was. Wages were placed on our marriage.
Like days, big time money weeks, was put. And all I told them was, yeah, mirko bata do. I would have made money. I would have made so much money on my marriage. Yeah.
Yes, it did affect me. Emotionally, it did affect me because I was getting into a new thing. And there have been nights when I've cried myself to bed. But you know what? What the fuck? I'm here 13 years. Eat this.
Love wins. So, what do you think? Is it healthy and important to dig into each other's past in the name of openness or?
Ah, good question. We were just talking about it.
Something my mother said, and she was a very, very evolved soul. She said, "Sab batane ki zarurat nahi hoti, thoda sa parda rakhna bahut zaruri hai."
So, how would you describe marriage to a young person or a teenager? I mean, your daughter is 18 now. To a young person who is too keen to get married.
A free roller coaster ride, which you never know when what turn is going to happen. So you rather, if you really want adventure, get married, or just go to an amusement park and pay $200 for a car.
Okay, that's his take. My whole thing is, take it easy.
How can you ever take it easy in marriage?
No. Take it easy. Itni kya jaldi hai? Ruk jao.
I took it easy and you're kicking my ass till day.
No, sow your oil seeds or whatever.
And everywhere?
See the world a little bit. Dekh daake, so much ke. My
daughter better not be watching this.
No, so I'm saying, okay, so live your life out. Okay, live your life out.
Kar rahi, okay, royal seeds, sow your royal seeds.
Meet the people that you have to and uske baad jahan
aapko lage. Thoda gobi ugalo, thoda pyaaz ugalo, thoda tomato ugalo, sow your royal seeds.
Just have fun before you commit, just check out everything.
But how, okay, same question, slight twist, that how would you describe marriage to a person who's avoiding it, a young person who doesn't want to get married?
Don't get married. If he's avoiding it, yeah, God is into God is telling him don't.
Yeah, divine intervention. Don't get married and never get married for anybody else's happiness and
joy. What an asshole! He's still looking for marriage. God is telling him don't.
It's your battle. Always remember, nobody ain't coming to help you here.
So on that note, we start our next segment, which is Let's Improvise. So, I'll give you both a condition, that'll be your truth, and we'll take it from there.
Yeah.
But keep listening to me because I'll be changing conditions.
Okay, got it.
So, Mana, you're Mihir.
Mm-hmm.
Mihir, you're Mana.
Uh-huh.
And your dog Cuddles needs to be taken out for a walk.
Okay.
And of course, both of you don't want to do it.
Okay.
But both of you have to convince each other to do it.
Huh.
Action.
I go first, I'm Mana. Yeah. I go to work, I fucking make money, and you want me to give a buck? maybe I'll get. You have to be me. Okay. I'll give her a bath. No, I do a better job giving her a bath.
But maybe I'll give her a bath.
I will fuck her happiness, but I'll still give her a bath.
Maybe, but I'll give her a bath. Now, what is your problem? The point is, bath has to be given. Bath has to be given. Whether it's given today or after 7 days, how does that matter?
But you have to give. But I have to give a bath. Not because you don't give a bath properly.
Yeah, because whenever you're
done.
Okay, so Mihir's favorite chachi is coming.
Yeah.
And Mihir's favorite
chachi. Doesn't have any favorites in relatives.
Uh-huh. But she has one
now. Okay, he has one. He has one now, and she's coming. Yeah. And somebody has to go take her, pick her up at the airport.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
And of course, Mihir wants Mana to do it.
Okay.
And Mana doesn't like the chachi too much.
Okay.
So she has to get out of it.
Yeah.
Action.
This is Mihir, right? Hana, I was just thinking, this chachi is coming, so can you just go like pick her up? I'm busy.
I'm Mana?
Yeah.
Listen, I hate your fucking family, but you know what? I love you. I'm going to do it, but I'm going to snipe you for the rest of my life. I'll go pick her up.
Baby, I was
you picked her up. You went to the airport, you picked her up, she came back. She's living at home. Relax. Next question.
So, what has been one of your darkest rock bottom moment?
Oh, in lots the of them.
Like one which stands out in this career, like I mean, given the career.
17 years that I've been here, there have been some 17,000 moments, but yeah, I mean, okay, well, should I talk about the Christmas tree?
Okay, yeah.
There was a time when Christmas tree, we talk about when we just got married, remember? There was this moment, she was doing a stand-up comedy show on, what was the channel, I don't
remember. Star One.
Yeah, Star One, and she was playing one of the stand-up comedians, and
I was a stand-up comedian.
Yeah, yeah.
On
okay,
that
you were a stand-up comedian.
And women weren't
and,
really given opportunity.
Yeah, and she was there with two other gentlemen, and they called her up and told her that you know, from today onwards, you'll be part of the gags and not the stand-up comedy. And I was dropping her to work, and she was very upset. And I said, you know what? If God willing, maybe I'm willing to lose my job for yours. And that's what I told her. I said, Bhagwan kare mera. In Naukri chale jaye, but you get to keep your job. She went, she got to be a stand up. Got back. And the day I said this, and I reached my set, and the day I finished shoot, my producer came and told me this is the last day because we don't need you from tomorrow. Yeah. So I actually lost my job for her.
Yeah, it was a very dark moment for us.
Yeah.
It was
and the worst part was, that was the first time I took my daughter to my shoot. And I was sitting there in my car, my daughter being all happy and frolicky.
Yeah.
And I was about to shut the door of my car, and my executive producer came and said, Mihir, we don't need you from tomorrow. And I was like, what? I said, yeah, you're fired. And I said, okay.
But
and I was very very emotional, I wanted to cry, but I just saw my daughter sitting there and I said, okay, you know what? Fuck it. You wished it, you asked for it. You cannot cry in front of your daughter. Move on.
But yeah, this rock bottom moment, this darkness has a certain beauty to it.
Oh, yeah.
And the best part, Vibhu, that next day we were flying to Delhi to celebrate our receptions with our parents because we hadn't told our parents about a marriage. And when we had, they had organized two receptions, one by my parents, one by her parents. Yeah. And just the next day we were flying to Delhi to attend all of that. And I lost my job. I got fired. My Sanjeevani finished. I got fired from my job. My monies hadn't come in.
So technically,
you know,
it
and,
was...
And there was a huge reception being held where my parents were paying for it, her parents were paying for it. And we were like, no, you know, whatever happens, we'll smile, we'll pay those bills however we can.
Yeah.
Let's go through this.
Yeah.
And how did you find like light in the tunnel with this whole
situation?
We
just laughed it off.
I think, we have an innate sense of, I think our mirth really... Pulls us through. And our mirth is not based on somebody else's, by deriving pleasure of, you know, as they say, mirth derived from misery is not mirth. So us, I think we just laugh with the situation. We cry together. We laugh together.
We just said we'll
have
cheaper alcohol.
We actually laugh a lot together.
We just said we'll have cheaper alcohol.
So we always find a way.
Yeah, the way I move from... cream biscuit to
parlor. Yeah, so we've always been like that. Yeah. So and the other thing being, I think.
See, it's simple. Somebody asks me, "What do you drink?" I say, "I have black." So they think, "Oh, you have Johnny Walker Black." I said, "No, DSP Black." I have black.
I think the most important thing is if you don't pass through those storms and turbulences, you will not be the person that you were meant to be. So we've always held each other's hands, and I've just lost both my parents, and it's.
Mm-hmm. We're not supposed to be part of this.
Yeah.
This
so anyway, life. It's the inevitability of life.
Sorry.
But yeah, but the good thing is that, you know, we stand with each other, we hold each other's hands, and to me this is marriage.
Each other's throats,
yes, to me this is marriage. When you know you can hold each other's hands and see me at my worst and still love me, that is marriage. See me in the morning or see him in the morning and still love each other, and you know, through fights, through arguments, through disagreements, through the worst things possible, that for me is marriage. That's how I define it.
And marriage is not perfect.
And marriage is not easy, it's not perfect, but you know what? When two souls decide that this is it, we will be together and we will be friends, to me that is a bond. That is very precious.
Yes. And with all that intensity of emotions, I think this is the right moment to start our new next segment, which is called Navras.
Yeah.
So it's about 9 emotions.
Yes.
And I just love you both. Yeah, so I'll give you both a dialogue to exchange.
Correct.
And you have to do that in 9 different emotions.
Got it.
And I'll give you the emotions and we do accordingly.
Yeah.
So, Mana, your dialogue is, main aaj khana nahi banaungi, tum bahar se order kar lo.
Give me the emotion. Yeah.
Mihir, your dialogue is, खाना तो तुम्हारे ही हाथ का खाऊंगा वरना भूखा सो जाऊंगा.
Yeah, it's a dream situation.
That was a genuine reaction.
मैं आज खाना नहीं बनाऊंगी, खाना तुम्हें बाहर से मंगवाना पड़ेगा.
खाना तो तुम्हारे हाथ का ही खाऊंगा वरना भूखा सो
तुम्हारे हाथ का ही खाऊंगा वरना.
Give us the emotions.
Okay, laughter.
First.
Laughter.
खाना तो मैं नहीं आज बनाऊंगी, खाना तो तुम्हें बाहर से ही मंगवाना पड़ेगा.
खाना तो मैं तुम्हारे हाथ का ही खाऊंगा लेकिन.
Compassion.
आज मैं खाना नहीं बनाऊंगी, तुम्हें आज खाना बाहर से ही मंगवाना पड़ेगा.
खाना तो मैं तुम्हारे हाथ से खाऊंगा वरना मैं
खाना नहीं खाऊंगा. Anger.
खाना तो मैं आज बिल्कुल नहीं बनाऊंगी, खाना तुम्हें बाहर से ही मंगवाना पड़ेगा.
खाना मैं तुम्हारे हाथ से खाऊंगा वरना मैं खाना नहीं खाऊंगा.
Surprise.
खाना तो मैं आज नहीं बनाऊंगी, खाना तुम्हें बाहर से मंगवाना पड़ेगा.
खाना तो मैं हाथ से खाऊंगा, सॉरी मैं बाहर से मंगवा लूंगा. I'm sorry, I give up on this impression.
Fear.
Oh God.
खाना मैं आज नहीं बनाऊंगी, खाना तुम्हें बाहर से मंगवाना पड़ेगा.
खाना तुम आज मत बनाना, मैं खाना बाहर से मंगवा लूंगा. Sorry, I'm changing the dialogue.
Courage.
खाना आज मैं नहीं बनाऊंगी, खाना तुम्हें आज बाहर से ही मंगवाना पड़ेगा.
आज मैं तुम्हारे हाथ का खाना खा के देख लेता हूँ, बनाओ.
Disgust.
खाना आज मैं नहीं बनाऊंगी, खाना तुम्हें आज बाहर से मंगवाना ही पड़ेगा.
आज मैं बाहर से मंगवाऊंगा, खाना बनाना बंद कर दो. I'm sorry, I'm in
peace.
खाना आज मैं नहीं बनाऊंगी, खाना तुम्हें आज बाहर से ही मंगवाना पड़ेगा.
दीदी आज खाना तुम ना ही बनाओ और मैं बाहर से मंगवा लेता हूँ.
ठीक है.
ओके एंड the most important, लव.
आज मैं खाना नहीं बनाऊंगी, आज ना तुमको खाना बाहर से मंगवाना पड़ेगा.
दीदी आज तुम टट्टी भी खिला दो मैं खा लूंगा.
Oh my god, that was awesome. You guys are just brilliant. So coming back to conversation, there's been like so much emotion flying around here, all sorts of
yes things. Yes,
like the censored ones and the non censored yes ones. So what's your mantra in life these days? I mean, it keeps changing, but what is it these days?
It's taken me very long to arrive here. Live in the moment is something that I've never learned to do. I confess I'm learning it. Live in the moment. It's very difficult for somebody like me, but I'm trying to grasp onto everything that's happening in the now. So it is, live in the moment.
Live in the moment.
And breathe.
I always believed, and I always believe in the saying, I mean, it's not said by me, it's said by somebody, but cross the bridge when you reach it. So every problem in your life is a bridge.
Yeah.
Stop fretting over it. How the hell am I going to do this? How the hell are we going to do this? How the hell are we going to do that? You know what? Reach the bridge first. You never know how big or small, how broken or not broken the bridge is going to be. So you're just fretting over something very stupid. So just reach the bridge and then decide how to cross it.
Yeah.
We always are fretting. कैसे करेंगे क्या करेंगे अरे पहुंचो तो सही वहां पे फिर देखते हैं क्या
दिस हैज बीन सो इंटेंस द बटन ऑफ माइन इज पॉप्ड
जस्ट मेबी इट्स नॉट इंटेंस द कैमरास आर गेटिंग हॉट
एंड
ही इज स्वेटिंग आई एम नॉट
आई एम
गुड यूइंग समथिंग राइट
या
लेट्स मी
एंड ऑन दैट नोट वी मूव टू आवर लास्ट एंड ब्यूटीफुल सेगमेंट wherein I bring out something really tiny and cute for you. Mihir, I have something for you too.
Nice, thank
this
you.
Is male grooming kit by the man company.
Wow. Yes. And he needed that.
Yes.
Wow.
So guys, thanks a lot for watching and we'll see you in the next episode.